Welcome, brother, sisters. Inshallah, tonight I like to talk about the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Adam. Adam alayhi salatu wasalam is the first prophet and also is the first man alayhi salatu wasalam. We as Muslims, we believe that Adam was the first man, the first human being. There were no people before Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Yes, there were before Adam jinn and angels. Okay, and we read this clearly in the Quran. وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً طيب وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned clearly when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam, Allah told the angels, okay, and Iblis was with them. Iblis is the main shaitan of jinn. He was with the angels. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed them, he told them to make sujood, to fall in prostration before Adam. Okay, so all of them did except Iblis. All the angels did except Iblis. So what do we understand from this verse in Surah Al-Baqarah and also other surah? That Adam is our father, the father of all human beings, alayhi salatu wasalam. Okay, so I like to talk a little bit more about Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, and you can find the story of Adam and information about Adam in the Quran. Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, as I mentioned, the first man. And also we should know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam from mimma wusifa lakum, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam mentioned, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has described for us. It means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam from a turab, from the soil. And you'll find in the Quran different stages of the creation of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. So the point, okay, I will not go in details about the creation, the stages of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, but the point that Adam, and also we can say the human beings, were created from the turab, the soil, the jinn from the fire, the angels from the light, an-nur. Tayyib. So Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was the first man, and Allah created his wife Eve, Hawa. In Arabic we say Hawa. In English they put Eve, from Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And some scholars say that Adam has no father, no mother. Eve has father and no mother. Jesus has mother and no father, and the other human beings with both parents, father and mother. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Eve from Adam, from the rib of Adam alayhi salatu wassalam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Adam and his wife Eve to live in paradise, to dwell in paradise. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Adam, don't eat from that tree, don't approach that tree. Which kind of a tree? Allahu alam. Is it an apple, orange, dates? Allahu alam. And it is not important, brothers and sisters, to know. Many times people try to find out what is the tree. Okay, and some of them say this is the tree of knowledge, and that's why it is not good to seek knowledge. Some people, subhanAllah, they are thinking nonsense way. So Adam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Adam and his wife Eve, don't approach that tree. And here there is an important thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَقْرَبَ هَذِي الشَّجَرَ. Don't approach that tree. Sometimes, because of the danger of that forbidding thing, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, don't approach. وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا وَلَا تَقْرَبَ هَذِي الشَّجَرَةِ فَاجْتَنِبُوا. Okay, avoid it. So to be away from the haram, this will be safer for us. Okay, yani maybe there's something forbidden on the table, so I tell you, don't eat. Okay, so there is risk that I will eat, I will disobey you and I eat. But to minimize that risk, I should tell you, don't approach that table. Don't enter that room. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, don't approach that tree. Okay, so subhanallah, the shaitan waswasa ila Adam wa Hawa, whispered to Adam and Hawa. How you'll find in the story of Adam, okay, not in the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not in the Quran. He went inside a snake, or he became a snake and he entered paradise, and he took all of these things not authentic by the Quran or Sunnah. And also, not important, we should believe and we take it as it came in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَوَسْوَسَ لَهُمَ الشَّيْطَانِ. So the shaitan did waswas for them. He whispered and he decorated the sin for them. And he said, أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمَ عَلَى شَجَرَةِ الْخُلْدِ. I'm going to tell you, if you eat from that tree, you will not die. You will have eternal life. طيب. So the shaitan, his way is to lie, subhanallah, and to decorate the batil, the false thing. And also, he used a very bad technique. He swore by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَاسَمَهُمَا إِنِّي لَكُمَا مِنَ النَّاصِحِينَ. The shaitan said, by Allah, I am a sincere person to advise you. But he was lying. يعني, may Allah protect us from the shaitan. So when Adam and Eve ate from the tree, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَبَدَتْ لَهُمَا سَوْآتُهُمَا. Subhanallah. Allah uncovered the body of Adam and Hawa because they ate from the tree because of the sin. طيب. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَطَفِقَا يَخْصِفَانِ عَلَيْهِمَا مِنْ وَرَقِ الْجَنَّةِ. They started to cover their bodies by the leaves of paradise. Subhanallah. So as a result, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Adam and Eve, now you should leave paradise and you go down to the earth. And also the shaitan with you, Iblis with you. بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٍ. He is your enemy. So subhanallah, brothers, sisters, we should realize that Allah made everything clear for us. So our mission is very easy if we follow the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not difficult. Why? Because as I said, Allah made everything clear for us. We know what is the right and what is the wrong. We know who are our friends and who are our enemies. So it is clear that the shaitan is our enemy. الشيطان لكم عدو فاتخذوه عدوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran clearly that the shaitan is your enemy. So consider him as your enemy. It means don't listen to him. Don't follow him. As simple as that. Subhanallah. And also we learn from that the impact and the result of the sins in the dunya before the akhirah. Okay? Many times we realize this. Because of the sins, we lose some of our money, we lose some of our health, we lose some of our barakah, blessings, because of the sin. There is a famous poem that one scholar said to other scholar, I have a problem in my memory. شَكَوْتُ إِلَى وَكِيعٍ سُوَ حَفْظِي فَأَرْشَدَنِي إِلَى تَرْكِ الْمَعَاصِي. I went to Waqi'. Waqi' is a famous scholar, Waqi' ibn al-Jarrah. So another scholar said, went to him and he said, I have a problem. I start to lose my memory, not like before. Difficult for me to memorize. So Waqi' al-Jarrah said, فَأَرْشَدَنِي إِلَى تَرْكِ الْمَعَاصِي, to stop the sins. He told me, don't disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because when you disobey Allah, Allah will take the blessings from you. If you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you'll find the things easy, to memorize Quran, to pray, to fast, to give charity. But if you keep away from the straight path, you'll lose the blessings. So this is very important. So because of that sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Adam and Hawa, you leave paradise and you dwell the earth, then later, after the death, you'll come back to paradise, Jannatul Khuld. So what happened also when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam, Allah told the angels, and also Iblis was with the angels, to do sujood, to fall in prostration before Adam. All of them did, except Iblis. Why? Because of arrogance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرَ. And this is a very important lesson for us. Some scholars say the first sin, the envy, the arrogance. Subhanallah. And what is the meaning of arrogance? Al-kibr, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-kibr batar al-haq wa ghamd al-nas. Al-kibr, arrogance, is not related with the nice clothes, nice shoes. It is to reject the truth and to put down people, to humiliate people. This is the kibr, as described by the Prophet, as defined by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So brothers and sisters, we should be humble. If anyone tells you what is haq, you have to follow. Don't insist to ignore and neglect the haq. So this is just a brief talk about Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Inshallah later we can speak more about other prophets. Jazakumullah khairan, brothers and sisters. And now if you have question or comment, you can write it down, inshallah. I'll give a few minutes if you have a comment or a question. Alhamdulillah, tonight is the 8th night of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our deeds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our prayers, our fast, our charity. Okay, if there is no question, okay, I give a few seconds to type your question if you have. Otherwise, we end the live Instagram. طيب محمد فرج السلام عليكم. I read somewhere that there were hen and bin before Adam. Peace be upon him. Yes, they mentioned, Ibn Kathir rahimahullah mentioned يعني الجن والمن والحن. Okay, الله أعلم about that. Ibn Kathir mentioned that. Okay, but did this came in the Quran or authentic hadith? الله أعلم. I did not see this. Okay, I did not see this. So is that authentic or not? الله أعلم. آمين يا رب. Yeah, subhanAllah, when you read in the stories of the prophets, okay, you will find a lot of information. But you have to make sure the information, is it authentic or not. And sometimes you will find, sometimes we read dangerous information. Some information don't contradict the Quran and the authentic Sunnah. So we have to be careful. That's why we should read from authentic sources. Be careful. Shahid, assalamu alaikum. My question is about Ramadan. Okay, what is the question? Abu Aisha. Sheikh, is there any angel, Nemes, Roman, in Kabr before Munkar and Nakir? I don't know, Allah. Any angel in the qabr, in the grave, before Munkar and Nakir? Allahu alam. Allahu alam. I don't know. If you have hadith, maybe you can share the hadith. Okay. What is the question, Brother Shahid? Because you write you have a question, why? WHI. طيب ما شاء الله. Okay, so are you typing your question or that's it? طيب. Okay, which one is better as a student memorizing Quran? Which one is better in Ramadan, to memorize or to revise? all the Quran from the beginning to the end? Well, it depends. Revising Quran is very important, because sometimes people read the Quran and they memorize the Quran without revising the Quran. Then they realize after a few months they cannot recall anything from the past memorization. So it is very important to revise the Quran. But now in Ramadan, I prefer in Ramadan we do like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He used to study the Quran with Jibril, to read, okay, to memorize, to understand. This is very important. So take the chance in Ramadan, you read the Quran every day, maybe 30 pages, one juz, and also to understand the Quran. This is very important. Take the chance to do this in Ramadan. Okay? And also if you are hafiz, and for example, for those who memorize the full Quran, it is very easy for them to review maybe two juz. It takes only 40 minutes from them. Okay, so maybe if they are driving the car or if they are at home, they can sit in the masjid. Okay, after every salah, they can revise maybe 10 pages or 20 pages for them. So it will be very good if they revise every day two juz. This is very, very good for them, inshallah. For reservations of place in masjid. Okay, when you enter the masjid, okay, try your best to go to the first line. Okay, some people, they keep their things in the first line in Maghrib Salah. They go home, then they come Isha. No, this is not right. This is not right. If you like to stay, if you like to pray in the first line, in the first row, you have to come early. You have to come early. But I put my cap, I put my chair in the first line, then I go home and I come. No, this is not correct. Okay, maybe sometimes I'm in the masjid, but I need to go to the toilet. Okay, so I put, for example, my cab here to show people that I'm going to the toilet or just to drink water and I come. This is okay, but I keep it for the next salah and I'm at home. No, this is not acceptable. This is not acceptable. Al-Hikmah. Is it allowed to hold the Mus'haf in hand and recite from it during Taraweeh and Tahajjud? Yes, it is allowed. Yes, it is allowed. I hold the Mus'haf, okay, and I read. Okay, and if you have a stand, you fix the Mus'haf on the stand and you read. Or for example, maybe you can read from your mobile. Allahu Akbar, and you keep the mobile in this way. Okay, but put the fly mode. Why? Because if you don't put the fly mode, maybe some messages come to your mobile during the salah, and you think about the messages and the WhatsApp. The people who die in Ramadan goes to Jannah. This is my daughter asking, as she read, the gates of hell are closed and gates of Jannah are open. No, not true. Because if the disbelievers die in Ramadan, they go to the hellfire. Okay, so we cannot say that all the people who die in Ramadan, Muslims and non-Muslims, they go to paradise. No, Muslims go to paradise, the non-Muslims go to the hellfire. May Allah protect us. Yes, the hadith, the gates of paradise are open. As the scholars mentioned, you'll find people easier for them to perform the ibadah. You'll find us, it is very easy to pray 20 rak'ah, 30 rak'ah, to fast every day, to give charity in Ramadan, because the doors of paradise are open. So anything more, or we stop here? Jazakumullah khairan. Anything more? خلاص. Okay. See you inshallah tomorrow. And or tomorrow we have the zakah class, inshallah 9 p.m. باذن الله. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.